please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Well, shares of cable TV service providers like Den Network and Hathaway Cables have extended their losses today despite already taking a big knock yesterday after RelJio launched that ultra-high-speed fixed-line broadband services. What will this do to the industry? What will it do in terms of pricing, competition? S.N. Sharma, the CEO of Den Networks, joins on the phone line to detail all of this. Mr. Sharma, good morning. Your own initial thoughts of what the impact of the JioGigaFiber could be on the overall industry, including companies like yours.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. We have been hearing about this for so many years. Now it has been formally announced. We welcome this development. I feel it is good for the sector. This shows the business potential in the sector that exists. And that too, when an entry by an organized big telco is made in a sector like ours, that brings a lot of attraction and attention to the sector, which was totally ignored. We have been maintaining that broadband services in India have been, fixed-line broadband services in India have been lagging. We hardly have 6% penetration as of now. India is a huge, huge market space. You have space for so many players to exist, to penetrate to 60% to 70% that normally is there in the existing developing countries. So I visualize a lot of attention in the sector, and that will make us also do the business properly. That will bring in a lot of technologies, developments in the sector. That will also mean robust business model need to be adopted by all the fellow cable players like us. As far as Den is concerned, we were consciously gauging these developments and have been developing our products depending upon the needs of the subscribers.
Okay.
And we recently, in fact, just 2 months back, we also announced a 100-city rollout plan that we are already covering for video services.
Yeah.
And it's a low capex-based plan with low ARPU model so that we can match up with the upcoming telcos
competition
entry into this.
Yeah, Mr. Sharma, you know, the fiber, the last, laying the last mile fiber could take time. So what kind of, you know, timelines are you looking at before you feel the heat of the competition? Will it be only FY20 or 21?
Well, it's very difficult to make any comment for a large telco like Jio. But with whatsoever experience I have in life and with our infra in place, I think it is going to take them a couple of years to extend to so many cities in the last mile beyond the microwave towers and microwave signals that they have already enabled.
Okay.
But let's wait and watch. Maybe you are right. It will take not less than 2 years
Okay. to cover up. But houses. Before that, you know, yesterday, of course, we spoke to a wide range of experts on this, and some obviously were pointing out that they will look at the large multiplex, you know, large buildings in cities like Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Bangalore, etc., and take over whole buildings. These are typically high ARPU areas, well-provided areas. So do you expect pressure on margins as early as this year itself?
See, as far as Den is concerned, we are consciously keeping away. But for Delhi, we haven't done extensive broadband in any of these cities where there is already a pressure on the tariffs.
Okay.
The tariffs have been continuously falling out of these telcos' upcoming features and the news that they will be venturing into. And we have planned our rollout in phase 2, phase 3 cities. As far as vertical towers is concerned, that is limited to Bombay and Calcutta. Even Delhi doesn't have vertical towers as of now.
Okay.
Majority of country, when you move out of Bombay, Bangalore and Calcutta, 80% of the country is still flatted structure. So it's going to take hell lot of time and a lot of resource will be needed to build up this kind
of thing. Of you are doing it. You know, there is a deep-pocketed Jio which is laying the last mile fiber, and all of you who are already in the field. So it could happen quicker. I mean, after all, mobile started off at 16 rupees a minute for about a year or so, and then when the flood came, it was billing in nanoseconds. So, you know, it may be slow in the first year. Do you think it will catch up pretty rapidly in the second year?
No. We have already seen extensive competition. We are competing with existing players like Airtel in city of Delhi. Around 2 years back, our ARPUs were in the range of 900. It has dropped down to 600 rupees already in city of Delhi. So we are consciously aware. That's why our upcoming plan, we are pretty confident that we'll be doing well even at 500, 550 rupees ARPU. And that is what we visualize it to happen eventually.
Okay, so you said 600 rupees is where the ARPU is currently. You know, JioGigaFiber is expected to launch at a price point of 500. You think that's something that will be okay for the industry? I mean, you'll still be able to function if you bring it down to that price point?
See, our, as far as DEN is concerned, I can make statement very confidently about DEN that at 500 rupees, our 100 city plan is all worked out and has been announced, and we are executing it.
Okay.
I am confident to maintain that, and I'll be able to service the my video subscriber at that price point. Not an issue. I can't make statement about others.
But will it also lead to, although you will be able to service at that price point, will it lead to more losses for the company? Because in FY18, you reported a loss of almost 20 odd crores. Should we expect more losses going ahead because of the pressure?
We have discontinued that model that we have got in city of Delhi. The model that we are adopting in 100 cities is a low capex based model, and we are confident of delivering 30% EBITDA as far as those 100 cities is concerned because of the different technology and modalities being worked out in the business plan.
Okay. No, sir, I was asking you about the full year for FY19. When do you think the company can turn into the black? Because you did report a loss of 20 crores in FY18.
Yeah. As far as 19, the prospects are quite bright and we'll see us turning black by the end of 19, definitely, in broadband as well.
Oh, that's good to hear. Mr. Sharma, it was a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on this very important issue. Usual disclosures, RelJio, or rather Reliance Industries, owns Network 18 and CNBC TV 18, therefore the channel that you are watching, and as does RelJio. So, disclosures on the table. With that, we shift to the markets.
Oh, yes. I think the Varroc Engineering listing will take place in just moments from now, in 2 minutes. So, expect it to be a good listing this time around. So, we'll keep our eye out on that. The upper end of the price band was 967. I think it's 1,000 rupee plus expectation of a listing. So, that those are the live visuals coming in of Varroc Engineering. That's Tarang Jain, by the way, the MD of the company. Remember, it has a great a great background. I mean, a good fundamental.
Pedigree.
yes, good pedigree, good fundamentals. It has exposure to the premium passenger vehicle market, etc. But the only thing is that that entire market has slowed down quite a bit in UK, North America. So that is the problem pocket for the company. But we'll talk about that in greater detail. For now, Ashwini Gujral, Mitesh Thakkar and Sandeep Wagle are also with us. Ashwini, the market has picked up actually quite a bit, up more than 100 points on the Sensex now. How would you trade the rest of the day?
See, don't have to trade all day. I told you to buy in the morning.
Yes.
You know, we are up, I think, 120, 130 from there on the Bank Nifty.
Yes.
That is the trade. Now, if you mess around in between the range, it'll be up and down. And I don't think buying 150 points from the lows is really a bright idea.
Mm-hmm.
So that way, index, we've taken off our profits here. But what's interesting is that, you know, stocks which were going down maybe because of trade war, like metals or IT or, you know, any of the HPBPs, they are now reversing. And this is a good time to get back into those stocks. So that way, you know, BPCL is a buy with a stop of 375, target of 393. Tata Steel is a buy with a stop of 550, target of 575. And Ashok Leyland is a buy with a stop of 124, target of 136.
Okay. Just a word, the Varroc listing is in few seconds, and it looks like a 5% premium listing.
Congratulations!
Yes, it is 5.5%, so 1020, and the offer price was 967, was it? Yeah, 967 was the offered price. And now, therefore, about 55 rupees higher, 56 That's a very good listing, you will have to say, under the circumstances.
It is.
But of course, it got good subscription.
Yes, it is a good listing. It got good subscription. And you know, if you go by the FY19 estimated EPS of around 27 rupees, it's now trading at 37 times FY19. Wow. So it's quite expensive as well. But it does have a very strong customer base. I mean, it has marquee companies like Ford, JLR, the Volkswagen Group, etc. in its portfolio. Of course, some of them are undergoing a slowdown. But so far, remember, in the domestic market, it's majorly present in the two-wheeler space. So Bajaj Auto was its first client. It has family connections there as well. TVS Motor was also its client. 50% of revenues comes from Bajaj Auto, and they are doing so well. So, you know, I guess maybe despite the global slowdown, it's hedged with sort of the local up move that we're seeing.
Yeah. Your note says 35% of the revenues come from the Indian two-wheeler manufacturers. Yeah. So even if the global manufacturers have seen some kind of slowdown, we know that the two-wheeler sector in India is doing reasonably well. Be that as it may, at the moment, it's getting lapped up. Let us see if it can maintain the opening premium 5% higher than the price at which retailers got the share.
I just want to mention one thing. You know, it is expensive, of course, at this price, but it is cheaper still than some of its peers like Endurance Technology. Endurance trades at about 40 times FY18. I mean, this is FY18, of course, forward. It's a little cheaper. But yes, compared to some of its peers like Madison now has fallen, but it's compared to historic averages, it is cheaper than Madison and Endurance Technology.
Fair point. Okay, let's get back to markets. Still doing well, but as Ashwini is warning, maybe you want to take your profits, especially if you had bought in the early morning dip. Mitesh, good morning to you. Have you also taken off your profits? First of all, did you take that buy on dip trade? Have you taken profit? What's the way forward on indices?
Yeah, Lata. So we didn't take the buy on dips on the indices, but we bought a lot of stocks. And Yes Bank, you know, I think gave a good opening, 2 rupees lower than yesterday. And I think that was a good entry point. So we had Yes Bank, but and yes, we have taken part profits. To be very honest, I think I'm not sure whether this market will immediately see a breakout beyond levels of 10,800, 830. So in that sense, we are now approaching the upper end of the range. But I still have two buy calls. Berger Paints, I think it looks like giving a fresh breakout. That's a buy with a stop at 290 for targets of 310. And LIC Housing Finance reversing from extremely oversold levels. Buy with a stop at 472 for targets of 490.
Okay, that's on LIC Housing Finance. By the way, the market has picked up actually quite a bit of pace. So the advance decline ratio, just take a look at that. More than 1,100 stocks now on the advancing side. Turning out to be quite a good Friday of trade. Sandeep, what about you? What stocks would you be looking at? I wanted also your thoughts on Ashok Leyland. I mean, that's a big gainer right now in the broader markets. How would you trade that?
Good morning, Sonia. I would start with Ashok Leyland. We have a view of 145, and that is for this expiry. So for the day, all the move has already come, probably maybe around 130, 131. That is where it can stop. But talk of this expiry, I think the stock has legs up to 145 or so. So at the current levels or on corrective moves towards 125, 126 with a stop loss of 122 and a target of 145. Stocks would be a buy on a Bajaj Auto, stop loss of 3012, target of 3060, and a sell in a Dabur, stop loss 376, target 363.
Okay. Well, Ashwini, I wanted to toss that to you as well. Ashok Leyland and Madison Sumi.
See, Madison, you would recall that we had given buy at 270, 280. These are the kind of times you have to get into those stocks. Ashok Leyland also, you know, 166 was the high. I think today is the day to buy into Ashok Leyland. Stops are fairly close by, 120 thereabouts. So I would think it should have a pretty good day, probably go much more than 5%. I wouldn't be surprised if you get, 144, 145.
All right. Okay, gentlemen, I know we have plenty of questions for you through the day. At the moment, the markets are still inching, crawling up. And from the day's low, of course, it's a fairly significant 100-point or what, 125-point gain on the Nifty Bank. So still, the early morning dips would work. But will the current buys work? At the moment, the advice from technical experts is maybe not. We'll take a break on that note. And thereafter, Akshali Shahar, the Senior Vice President, Strategy Sales,